Hello, Medicine Hat. I'm sure that over the weekend you may have saw the viral post that was shared by almost everybody. It's a picture of a hot dog with a nail in it that was supposedly thrown into a local person's yard, possibly in an attempt to harm their pet dog. I wasn't able to meet up with a veterinarian to discuss what kind of problems this could cause for an animal before airing this story, but I think we can all surmise that it's probably not good for a pet to eat a hot dog with a nail in it. Barring an interview with a veterinarian who could tell us all about the harms that may come from this, I do have an interview with the gentleman who whose yard was picked.
My name's Mark Elkin. I live in Medicine Hat now for almost 3 years with my wife and my son. And my dog here, he's 2 years old now in the end of May. And he's really just become a part of my family. You know, I used to work out of town and it was hard being away from a young child. So now I get to spend my days walking my dog and living with my family. So,
how long have you been a dog owner?
Well, periodically throughout my life, but most recently since we got him two summers ago. So,
yeah. And so describe to me what happened yesterday morning.
I took him out in the morning before I went to work, and it was just like a normal time. He went down off the deck and did his dog stuff and came back upstairs. And so I put him back in the house, and then I realized I was still a little early for work. So I went back into the yard to do some cleanup. And that's when I noticed along my fence line there appeared to be these little bits of hot dog, which I thought were weird. I don't eat hot dogs very often, and I certainly don't throw them out. So I bent over to pick one up, and the first one I picked up had a little chunk of metal sticking out of it, and I realized it appeared to be about an inch long framing nail or something. And at first I thought it was the only one, but as I continued to clean it up, I found two more chunks, and one of them, the nail was buried so deep in you couldn't even see it poking out. It wasn't until I cracked open the wiener that I found the nail sticking out.
How did you feel when you found those?
I felt pretty scared, actually. It was kind of not common of my experience in Medicine Hat to experience that sort of thing, and it was pretty scary to think about what could have happened if my dog had gotten to it first. And then it kind of started wondering if it had happened to other people, so I called the Medicine Hat Police Service, and they dispatched an officer who came and helped me take a look around my neighborhood. And that's when we discovered that another one of my neighbors had found similar bits in their yard.
And was that a dog owner as well?
It is, yeah. They have two smaller dogs.
What does that make you think, that somebody's possibly targeting dog owners?
Yeah, I think someone might either have had bad experiences with dogs or can't own a dog and might just not appreciate them for, you know, being part of the family. And I think it's scary because I also have a young son who could have been in the yard and could pick it up. And what could have happened if he had put it in his mouth, kind of thing. So yeah, it's definitely an eye-opener that you need to make sure you know what's in your yard if you have anybody that likes to spend time outdoors. You know, even just standing on it could be dangerous. So I think, yeah, it's pretty scary that someone's walking around the neighborhood potentially trying to harm people and their pets.
What was your neighbor's reaction to that?
My neighbor was actually pretty petrified because they didn't know that the bit had a nail in it, and as far as I know, they caught their dog actually eating one of the pieces and were unable to get the piece away from their dog.
So that might be a trip to the vet then.
It might be, yes. I have seen the dog out since then and it looks to be okay, so I'm hoping that it either A, didn't have a nail in it, or B, managed to spit it out or something.
Yeah. What about the comment section? I saw your first post and I saw the picture of the hot dog and I was like, wow, I gotta talk to this guy. And then I started reading the comments and I was like, it's a strange thing to be conspiratorial about, maybe.
Well, I mean, I don't know. It's Medicine Hat. It's not a large city, but I guess people don't have too much time on their hands. I was criticized by my wife. I was told that I shouldn't post something like that and then leave without having service on my phone. So I did get a call from her during the day that I needed to try and get things under wraps, but I was out in the middle of a field somewhere with no service, so the data was really slow, and in the end I couldn't get it
Some people working, had questions. They thought you weren't answering.
Yeah, I mean, I was accused of all sorts of things, even trying to fake the attack, and I feel bad for my neighbor who might have seen that and know who I am, and then start jumping to conclusions, or anybody that was jumping to conclusions. I mean, just because someone's busy in their day and maybe can't answer right away, that's no reason to be assuming anything.
What do you say to those people who were like, there's not enough dirt on the hot dog for it to be real?
I mean, not everybody knows 100% of the details, and I understand that the post that I made on the Medicine Hat Pet Advice group was pretty vague. I didn't have a lot of time. Immediately after the officer left, I had to go to work, and not a lot of details were supplied, but not enough people took the time and patience to ask more details before jumping to those conclusions. My yard is 100% gravel. I don't, like, there's not even weeds in it, so I assume the bits weren't there that long and therefore couldn't have gotten too dirty. But I know a lot of people look into their yard and they say, well, if I threw something in my yard, it would get covered in dust and dirt and grass and leaves and whatever else. And that's not the case for some people. So I think a lot of people just weren't patient and tried doing their own investigating. So
yeah. I wanted to wait until I talked to you. I was like, well, I'll hold off on any kind of judgments until I meet the person. I think that's important sometimes. What do you think is important for, like, other, like, is there anything that we should tell other pet owners, or any words of caution, or what do we get from all of this, you know?
I think definitely be vigilant with your pets. I know many, as well as I do, believe that their pets are a very large part of the family, and I mean, you look through your groceries before feeding them to yourself, and I think it's the same thing, is you just need to be aware of the surroundings, and just if you have a spare moment every day or a few times a day, even just go and double check and make sure there's nothing, because I mean, it could have not been nails, it could have been poison or anything that was on these. So I think just making sure that you check. I think if anybody has a problem with anybody in general, I mean, if it was less of an attack on my pet and more of an attack on me, if I angered somebody, I think it's 100% more effective to come and talk to that person instead of trying to go behind your back and try and take away things you love. So
yeah.
I think, in general, I think it's a dirty thing to do to try and harm someone's pet.
Is there some fear there that you know somebody out there who's trying to get you, or?
No, I don't believe so. My neighbor's window was broken on their car the other day, and I went and talked to them, and apparently they broke it on themselves. They slammed the hatch too hard, so
yeah.
So I don't believe that I have anybody malicious after me, so.
Right on. Hey, thanks so much for talking
to
me.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm going